Correct. And I'm guessing you also must be asked this question a lot, especially from this section of the media, is that Bollywood films and now there's attention so much on you of people who have not watched your work are now suddenly going to start seeing you, following you. The option of working in the Hindi film industry is always open and offers come. And now actors are becoming pan-India actors. It's not just for a certain language, right? What is your take on that? How do you plan to look into that space?
See, I love Bollywood movies, and Bollywood is blessed with a lot of amazing actors and technicians and filmmakers. So, I don't think I have to do a Bollywood movie just for the sake of doing it. I'll do a Bollywood movie if the movie, if the character demands me, or else it'll look odd if I come and do a character here if it's not suiting me. And yeah, I think I'll keep doing Malayalam movies, and maybe Malayalam industry will grow, and along with that I'll also grow. Maybe I can attract everyone to Malayalam industry. Like, I watch Korean movies and Spanish movies. What I had this thought I had from the beginning of my career, like, if I can enjoy Korean movies, why can't Koreans enjoy Malayalam movies? Because I don't know Korean language, they don't know Malayalam language, and I can watch a Korean or Spanish movie, and if I can like it, they also can like my movie. So I don't want to go and act in all the industries. I would like to explore. I would like to explore the work culture in every industry, and I would like to learn a lot from all the actors and technicians from all the industries across the globe. But I think I can perform the best in Malayalam, and Malayalam movies are not bad either. So when Malayalam movies are in the spotlight, I think I should keep on doing Malayalam movies, and I should be able to take Malayalam movies all over the world.
I absolutely love this philosophy. I think I'm so happy that you think, I mean, you have this thought process going on right now. It's really exciting to know that. We are also wrapping up the year. We are almost at the end of the year. I quickly want to check with you and talk to you about what has been your favorite stuff that you watched this year in the OTT space or otherwise across languages, anything that you've really enjoyed watching.
A lot of them. Squid Game, I loved it. And the final episode of Money Heist, I loved it. And those series are very inspiring. How to use Netflix to become international. That's what I that's what that's the inspiration I got from these series. And I watched many other series. I had a lot of free time this year. In Kerala, we had a second lockdown, and I was at home for a very long time. So the only thing I used to do was watch movies. And also, I'm very happy that I could do few movies which got national level recognition. Minal Murali is going to release now. My previous release was Kaane Kaane, which is in Sony.
Yes.
And that also got great reviews. And Kala released in the
Yes.
in June, I think, in Amazon Prime, and it also got very good reviews for the movie, for the content we spoke about, and for our performances. So, and the director's craft, everything was being discussed. Earlier, it used to be discussed only in Kerala. Now it's being discussed all over India. This year has been a very good year for me. In terms of movies, in terms of exciting projects which I'm doing right now, and I have a very hopeful 2022 also. I'm looking forward to 2022 very hopefully, because I have some amazing movies which I believe are amazing. They're ready. They're coming out after Minal Murali. It might be Naaradhan, directed by Ashu Kabu. It might come out in Jan. The details, we'll share it soon. So I'm very happy that I could watch a lot of amazing movies this year. I could be part of many amazing movies this year, and next year will be even better, I think.
Fantastic. So my last question before we wrap up is for fans, your fans and fans who are expectedly awaiting to see the film, Vinal Murali, what do you have to say to them?
Minal Murali is a movie in which me, Basil, Samir Kha, and the whole team, the producers, all the technicians, all the actors, we have done our 100%. We have put in our 100% effort. coming from a from an industry where we cannot demand for a huge budget like what Marvel or DC gets, we tried and made a movie which is going to compete with those movies only, because from audience perspective, they have to spend same amount of money to watch a Malayalam superhero movie and a Marvel or DC superhero movie. So there will be comparisons. They'll think, why should I spend this much for a Malayalam movie? If I can spend this much and watch a movie of 1,000 or 2,000 crores budget, then why should I watch this Malayalam movie? So I have to say this, like I, as a audience, I always wanted movies to connect, emotional connect should be there. And emotional dramas are Malayalam movies' strong points. So me and Basil, we are also very emotional people. And we also believe that apart from the superhero elements, there should be something else in the movie. Not only superhero elements, we have humor, we have emotional scenes, we have nice defined characters. So I think this is a full package, and we have done our best with whatever we got. And I think it has come out good. And from the trailers and all, you might have seen what it is, what the premise, the scale, everything. So it's not just another superhero movie. This is a very grounded, desi superhero movie, which will make you laugh, which will make you probably cry, or which will give you goosebumps at some moments. So that's what I expect. And I watched this movie first time with my parents and my wife and my kids. It was Basil's wedding anniversary, and I went there to wish him, and he had the movie. That was not the final out, but we all sat and watched it together in his home theater. And my parents, they loved it. My wife loved it. Usually my wife, whenever she watches a movie of mine, she's the a cold-hearted critic in my house. Like, if I do something wrong, she'll say it on my face, because she doesn't have to impress me anymore. Take whatever she says, because she says that for me to improve. So usually whenever I do something wrong, she points it out. But in Minnal Murali, she told me, I don't have anything to say. I don't have anything critical to say. You have done an amazing job. The movie is too good. I loved it. That's what my wife said. My dad, he broke into tears after watching the movie. He had mixed emotions. And my daughter, me and Basil watched the movie from her face, not on the screen. So we were looking at her face, and I could see the excitement in her eyes, and every humor scenes, every emotional scenes, every fight sequences, she enjoyed it. She's just 6 years old, and superhero movies, I think, is for kids and kids inside us, and she enjoyed it. So I think people from every part of the world, people from different genders or different age groups can enjoy this movie. It's a small movie. Compared to all other huge superhero movies. But I think it's worth it.
Absolutely. I think if the wife loves the film, that's a good sign. And yeah. on that note, wish you all the very best for not just Minnal Murali, but for everything else in 2022. This was an amazing chat. And hope to speak to you soon, Romino. All the very best.
Thank you so much, Tushar.
Take care. Bye.